council estate with my mum and my brother and sister. We didn't really have any money when we were growing up at all. We used to share clothes, we used to, like, mum only got what she got to pay for food. You know what I mean? We didn't have anything flash, we were just living in a little council house. But yeah, we were basically on rations for a lot of years, to be fair, if I'm going to be completely honest. We couldn't afford to do much, so we just used to pull mattresses off at bed and fly downstairs on it. My dad was a DJ in the 90s. He used to take me to sets with him to set up and stuff when I was with him. I just used to love listening to, like, house music growing up in the 90s. And my dad's Irish, so I listened to all different kinds of music with them, and as well as the 90s kind of speed garage and techno and stuff that he used to listen to. And my mum's side are Italian, so we used to listen to Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, Bocelli and stuff growing up with them. And there was just a vast selection of music in my household. I've always just had music around me. I used to write poems, and I started emceeing, and then my mum said, "Oh, I want to take you to a recording studio," because everyone used to come to my house all the time. God, I'd always be the one emceeing. I'd have a few friends who used to do it when we were kids and stuff like that. And my mum said, "I'll take you to the studio." So I went to the studio and I burnt like 5 CDs. And one of the CDs that I gave to a friend, he started burning it and selling it at school. Somehow that CD got into the Leeds Market. Now the Leeds Market stall is like a really cool place to be. It's where you got all the underground music that you couldn't get from HMV at the time. You got the DJ sets that were getting played in the clubs. You got it at Leeds Market, and it was like where everyone used to go on the weekends to get music. I was just walking through one day when I was like 15, 16, and the guy in the market went, "Yo, Tom Zanetti," and I was like, "Yo," and he went, "Your CD's best selling CD, it's been coming, have you got any more?" And I was like, "Whoa." Than all of the girls. My first track I got signed with Darling, and that done really well. But Darling and You Want Me, them two tracks, they'd been out for like 5, 6 years before they got signed. They was already doing the circuits in Leeds and in Manchester and up north, and so they already built a bit of static. That's how Darling got on radio. Target wanted to play it on radio, and when he played it, he rang me after. He said, "That's one of the biggest responses I've had for a song in God knows in forever. I want to get it signed." So he signed it. But before that, them songs had been bubbling for years and years. There wasn't Instagram when I was 15. There was when I was 17 when I threw my first parties. Facebook wasn't even about. I used to stand outside Space Club every Thursday night religiously with CDs that I've burnt off to promote my party. I used to set time for myself where I used to message every DJ that I could think of, all the DJs that were in Leeds and all these other places, every day. And for everyone in Leeds, all DJs that are older than me, they all know me for that, because that's what I did, because that's the only way you could get heard. Style is important. It's how you represent yourself, and you can do whatever you want with it. You can be as loud as you want. So I think style is a great way to show your personality. I've worn shirt and trousers since I was a kid, since I threw my first party at 17. Everyone else were like in what were trendy, and I'd be wearing a shirt and a belt and some shoes, and I looked a bit daft, but I always like to present myself like that. This tracksuit at the minute is really clean, really fresh. It looks good, obviously, so I try not to really follow too many trends and do my own thing. In Leeds, you could go out by yourself and you'll make a million friends and you just have a great time, and it's all different people. You could have all different types of people from all walk of life in one club, and everyone just together dancing. And I think that's the great thing, like you could go out by yourself and just make friends. Whereas I feel like in certain other places you might, it could be a bit, you know what I mean, it's a bit like bougie and stuff like that, where a northern quality I feel like is being a welcoming person. I like to be welcoming and make people feel like they're in good company. I've been asked every year to come on TV shows, all different TV shows, and I've never done it, because if it's been a dating show, I've always had a girlfriend, or I've been working, or I've been away on tour, I couldn't commit to it. And I've missed loads of opportunities, if you like, and I've kind of always wondered what it'd be like. And I'd never seen it, I'd never seen Celebs Go Dating, I'd never seen any shows, and I didn't even watch it. I had to quarantine in a hotel for 10 days before I went in the mansion. But I still like didn't watch it. I thought, I'm gonna go in and just like not know what's going on, and I'll just do anything. You're just gonna party for a month with a load of birds, you'll be dating a different bird every day. And I went to Deacon, looked at him, and he went, "Are you mad?" I said, "Get on that show." So I said, "You heard him, yeah. Right, sign me up, let's go." Me and a 10 been talking. My son's 14 now. And like, he's just the best he's ever been. Like every day, I think he just gets better and better all the time. Like the relationship we've got now is just as strong as when you were a proper daddy's boy when you were a kid. I just love being a dad, you know, so, and I love, I just love my boy, and I won't have it any other way. Growing up, when I started seeing how I can make money, and I started making money, and I could give money to my mum and my brother and my sisters, and I could start doing nicer things. It just made me want, and I just suppose I just wanted to do it. I really wanted to just work and work and work until I could do it. Just get into it, just protect your mindset, keep busy, crack on and try and make the best of a bad situation, because you can only get somewhere if you keep moving forwards. You know what I mean? So get up this morning, get a shower, get ready and just fight head on, because you've got to do it. If you're hungry and you want to do it despite how hard it is, you will get there. Do you know what I mean? And that sounds really cliche, but if you're hungry and you know where you're going and you work towards that, you're going to do it. It's inevitable. You can't, as long as you work hard for it, you're going to get there. The thing that I love the most is her time. What we got is a lot deeper. She do her thing and I do mine. I'm never going to mistreat her. The thing that I love the most is her time. So I don't stop. Eye contact and I can't stop, won't stop. She want it hard and I